rate of reaction. Rate of reaction can be defined as the change in concentration of reactants or products in unit time is called rate of reaction. So rate is equal to it can be with respect to the decreasing of concentration of reactants and with respect to the rate of reaction can be defined as the change in concentration of reactants or products in unit time is called rate of reaction. With respect to the reactants, rate is equal to decrease in concentration of reactants upon time period or unit time. With respect to the products also, increase in concentration of products in time period, in unit time. In a chemical reaction, what happens? Decrease of concentration of reactants with the time will take place, and increasing of concentration of products will take place. So we can define rate of reaction with respect to the reactants and with respect to the products in a given time. So how we express the rate of reaction? Rate of reaction can be expressed in terms of moles per liter upon second. Rate of reaction can be expressed in terms of moles per liter and second is the rate of reaction. If you want to understand rate of reaction more detail, let us take one example. Let us consider one hypothetical chemical reaction we should consider. In this hypothetical chemical reaction, R is utilized to the products. R represent reactants and products, P represent products. Now I am taking R, n moles, one mole of R I am taking. At t equal to 0 time, R will be, so no change in that reaction, not started, no product is appeared. At t equal to t1 time, the concentration of R will be, change will be R1, and the products appeared will be the P1. At t equal to t2 time, R will be the R2, then this is P will be the P2, P2 appeared. At total t time, the total time means time required for completion, concentration of reactants will be 0 and the products will be the one mole disappeared. From this, what we can write, the rate is equal to R2 minus R1, T2 minus T1. So, the difference between final concentration of reactants, initial, in the given time interval, is called define average rate. Average rate can be defined as the rate of change of concentration of reactants in a given intervals of time period is called average rate, we say. And when the time is, when this delta T time is decreases to small, we'll get the rate of change of concentration of reactants also discrete, that is called instantaneous rate. So let us discuss this average rate and instantaneous rate by using, by plotting the graph between reactants versus the time. Here I am taking time on the x-axis and molar concentration of reactants on the y-axis I am taking. So when the reaction starts, concentration of reactant decreases, we'll get the curve. T equal to 0, here the T equal to 0. At T1 time, concentration of reactants will be R1 I2. At T2 time, concentration of reactants is R2. This is T2 time here. The difference between final to initial, which is, this is delta R difference. So this line indicates delta R and this line indicates delta T time interval. This indicates the time interval and this indicates concentration difference, which is equal to R is equal to R2 minus R1 upon T2 minus T1, which is called average rate. This average rate is equal to delta R upon delta T. Okay, so when the delta T time, this time interval is decreased to 0 upon by applying the limit. Delta T is applied means increase it to 0, then we'll get R equal to minus T. D indicate